Tanya Plibersek is Minister for the Status of Women has claimed opposition leader Tony Abbott couldn't handle strong women like the Prime Minister and Speaker Anna Burke.
I think he does find it very difficult that he's dealing with two women in positions of authority.
Another strong woman is Tony Abbott's sister, Christine Forster, now running as Liberal candidate for Sydney City Council. Christine, thanks for joining me. What did you make of Plibersek playing the sexism card against your brother?
Andrew, look, I believe that Tanya Plibersek is going at Tony. She can't go at him on his policy, so they're just playing the, as you say, playing the sexist card because they can't get him in terms of his policy. Well, we all know it's rubbish. I mean, Tony's surrounded by strong women. He has a beautiful wife, three beautiful daughters, three sisters, a female chief of staff, a female deputy. He is surrounded by strong, independent, articulate women.
Now, look, some commentators have had trouble imagining you as in the same party as Tony, especially because he doesn't believe in gay marriage, but you do and are in a committed lesbian relationship. How do you and Tony fit in the same Liberal Party in your view?
Well, look, Andrew, the Liberal Party is a broad church. There is a lot of debate, a lot of difference of opinion, and that's a really great thing. Yes, I'm very much in favour of marriage equality, and Tony's on the record as being in favour of the Marriage Act as it stands. But that doesn't exclude one or the other of us from being in the Liberal Party, because, as I say, there's room for debate.
Well, it's interesting, this notion of the Liberal Party seems to be in flux, or at least is challenging a lot of people. For example, again, in the Northern Territory last week, the Country Liberal Party won big because it chose four Aboriginal candidates, including a woman I admired, Bess Price, who all won seats that used to be heartland Labor. What does this tell you about the Liberal Party today?
Well, look, I think it's a fantastic reflection of the Liberal Party and just how much it's opening up to the people of Australia. And it's a wonderful thing that there are Indigenous leaders being able to represent their own communities. What a fantastic thing.
But what is it about the Liberal philosophy that encapsulates, you know, you and Bess Price and also Tony?
Well, look, the Liberal philosophy is all about respect for the individual and respect for individuals' views. And I guess I reflect that and Tony reflects that and a person like Bess does as well. That's what the Liberal Party is about. It is about respecting each other and diversity of opinion and having those voices heard.
The Liberal Party, you're standing in the Sydney City Council. What sort of liberal values do you want to bring there?
Well, look, we're about safer streets for Sydney. We're about cutting wasteful spending in council. I mean, that's very much a liberal value. Lean, efficient government. And what we want to do is get council back to core business, listening to its constituents, listening to its local residents and supporting local businesses. Liberals obviously are about supporting business and that's very much what we want to bring to the City of Sydney Council.
And Tim Tams, how did that come to be an election issue?
Well, Tim Tams are just an example of Clover Moore's nutty schemes, Andrew. I mean, it's a ridiculous idea that council would jump up and down about people bringing a biscuit into council. And it's nuts. And we're about common sense. That's a core liberal value, I believe. Common sense government. And that's what we want to bring back. Forget this silly ideas like banning Tim Tams.
Christine Ford. Thank you so much for joining me.
My pleasure, Andrew.
And that's the show. But before I go, I've always said actors should stay out of politics. But Clint Eastwood, he's a legend, a conservative, and the sensation of the Republican convention, which this week nominated Mitt Romney, the billionaire businessman and former governor, to run against Barack Obama. The left mocked Eastwood's routine with an invisible Obama.
Yeah, I never thought that it was a good idea for attorneys to be president anyway, because I think it's maybe time, what do you think, for maybe a businessman? How about that?
They mocked, but this is Clint Eastwood. Made my day, and happy Father's Day to you too. Meet the Press is next. Until next week, goodbye.